I, Prophet Jeremiah Mudofufuyi, I am here to inform all the general public that who are all there watching Mercy Television Plus and Mercy TV. Right now, I am here to inform you that there is a great program that's coming up right now on the June 15, 16. And it will be a great program that's going to now touch many lives. Wherever you are, you need this one. Who ordained you? Who ordained you? Who ordained you is a question that I am now asking every person that out there. Right now, there are two category kind of people that God has created. There are some people, God has given them ordination, direct ordination. Some people, they now go under somebody for ordination. And ordination, in other words, ordination, when somebody lay hand on you, somebody who is out begin to now lay on you with water or with oil. That's what I'm talking about. When you look at the story I am talking about, when I now look at the story of Master Jesus, Jesus Christ was gone. He has gone to a great man of called John. John ordained him. In other words, we call it baptism. He now lay, he's also, you know, put it up and he now baptized him. That's all. That's why they whosoever that's called, I'm talking about water ordination. And another one I'm going to talk about is oil ordination. We have water ordination and oil ordination. When John ordained Jesus Christ, our Father, and Jesus greater than him. Why? Because he followed, he respect the word of his master. And also, something happened, a young man called Samuel. Samuel went to Jesse's house and ordained King David. Today, King David is greater than Samuel. Why? I'm saying this word because David was submissive to Samuel. Whosoever that ordained you, you have to be submissive to the person that who ordained you. It's a question. Have you never seen a pastor, a great man of God, came to my church? This is a GO, general overseer of a ministry. He came to my ministry and I prophesied to him and I told him about his life. What happened to his life? This man was having a great ministry, is many people, congregation, but something just happened. One day, he now gone to Ugeli from Wori, he now gone to Ugeli. He relocated to Ugeli. Powers from nowhere began to pull him down. When they pulled him down, what happened? This man just go to Ugeli and now walk under somebody and he became a member of a church. Oh, what such a life is this? A GO, general overseer of that matter, turned to a member, a church. In the church, it's a pity. Who ordained you? Because he has no ordination. The Bible says this ordination has gone wrong. Somebody, look at this. Ananias ordained Saul, and Saul is greater than him. Then let me tell you something. The Bible says a great man of God called Elisha. Elisha and Elijah. Elijah ordained Elisha, and Elisha done greater things upon the kingdom of God. And what I'm now also telling you, I'm seeing a great man of God called Moses. Moses was performing great things, and he's a great man of God. Something just happened, and this man ordained, Moses ordained Joshua. And Joshua, only one miracle that Joshua performed is greater than all the miracles that Moses has done. Why? Because the miracles that he performed, they are uncountable. Moses performed uncountable. Hey, you see, Red Sea divided. And you, hey, you stick, stabs, turn to a snake and turn to a snake and swallow the enemies. All those things, but one only miracle that his son Joshua performed is greater than all. He says, son, stand still. No man has beaten that record. Son, the living son, the Lord's son that God has created, nobody can stop it, but Joshua stopped it. Who ordained him? It was Moses that ordained him. It's a program that's coming up. Once I ordained you, this ordination that I ordained you with oil, brother, sister, I don't know. Whatever thing that God has given to me, the speed I am going, your speed is greater than my own. Except you will not obey me. Except you will not respect or you will not believe what I am doing. Or except you are not taking me as your spiritual father. Except you are not following my rules and regulations. So whosoever that out there, you wants to now you obey the footstep of your spiritual father, then also you begin to now make it higher than everybody. What I've said just now, you can see everything. Who ordained you? That's the program that coming up, live and direct. Look at that man. This one's got a businessman and business women also. You're a businessman, you can come over. Listen, look at that young man that who have helicopters and canoe, helicopters, plane, and others. Not one plane, not two planes, not helicopter, not the engines of helicopters, but now planes and others. He was having planes and helicopters. What happened to him? Because he was not ordained. He has no spiritual father. Because this man now become a worker. Become a worker who have helicopters and planes. Become a worker to a company called Max Air Limited. Why? Because he was having no spiritual father. Nobody ordained him. You are a businesswoman. You are a businessman. You have to come over. Only 1,000 people is going to register. Only 1,000 people that I want, ordain. Only 1,000. Look at the screen. Call them. Book fast. Only 1,000. The first batch is 1,000 people that I'm about to ordain, live and direct. 1,000. If you don't book fast, I cannot. Now, June 15 and 16, Mercy City, I am waiting for you. I, Prophet Jeremiah Motofufuyin, I am waiting for you because you need ordination. Let me tell you, some people are ordained by God, and some people, the people that God ordained them, they also ordained people. Listen carefully. The people, Moses, nobody ordained him. It was God that ordained him, correct calling, direct calling, and he ordained Joshua, and Joshua is greater than him. Elijah was ordained by God. God called him, and he ordained Elisha. Elisha also bigger than him. All the things that I have today, God has blessed me today. If you are a son, you are a daughter, that you are coming for this ordination, your life, you will make it more than I do. Because it is written, it is biblically, whether you like it or not. Look at this thing, how you're going to register. For more information, the numbers are rolling on the screen. Call them. They will tell you what to do. Before too late, because the first batch, after the first batch, it will take time before I will do this program again. I am waiting for you. I am Prophet Jeremiah Motofufuyin. I am waiting for you. Come! Don't waste time. It will be active. It will be explosive. Your ministry is cropping. Your business is cropping. Ah, you must come back like Jeremiah. Omo. You will get to receive your blessings. Speed! Fast! Like Jeremiah. You can see me. God has ordained me today. You can see me. What the Lord has done is uncountable. It is the Spirit of God that will dwell in me, that's speaking for me. So also it's going to speak for you. The Bible says in the book of 1 Samuel 10, 11, I read, and it came to pass when all that knew him before time saw that, behold, he prophesied among the prophets. Then the people said one to another, what is this that is come unto the son of Kish? And who ordained him? That's something that I want to tell you right now. Now they asked, Saul prophesying every kind of thing that you were prophesying. Every kind of prophecy was prophesying. We have many pastors out there. They can prophesy, they can heal, they can deliver. But who ordained you? If you don't have a spiritual father also ordained you, before you know, your ministry begin to have problems. Because you need a mountain to cover you, a mountain to guide you, a mountain to guide your business, a mountain to now guide your marriage, a mountain to guide anything you are doing for success. What is the mountain that guided you? What is the mountain that you're walking? In Israel, every successful man have a spiritual father. They have gone for ordination. That's why today, politicians that who started today, before they know, they died untimely dead. Why? Because they don't have somebody to ordain them. They don't have spiritual father. Now, I want to ordain people, politicians, businessmen, also ministers of God, men and women, boys and girls. I am waiting for you. You are a child of God. Come over. 1,000 persons only. 1,000. Call the line that who am that on the screen. Call them for more information. 1,000. I'm waiting. So I am waiting for you. Right in Mercy City. Come and take your double impactation. Double. You greater than what I am doing. And also God is going to bless you. May God bless you all. As you come, I'm waiting for you right in Mercy City. Warri, Delta State, Nigeria. No time for you to now be there anymore. You need higher to go higher. May God bless you. I'm waiting for you. I remain your prophet, Jeremiah Motofufuyin. Omotofufuyin. Omotofufuyin. Owama. God bless you.